I also want to welcome you to this very, very exciting event on valuing and accounting for the environment in Asia. My name is Rike Hansen, and I work in the statistics division of ESCAP, focusing on environment and economic statistics. As you've noticed from the program, and also from my fellow welcomers, this event is fundamentally about the need to integrate information across the different pillars of sustainable development: economic, environment, and social. And this is a need that has emerged from changing development challenges and changing policy priorities. Traditionally, the structure of our statistical systems have largely treated these three pillars of sustainable development separately, rather than encouraging and supporting integration of information across these three pillars. It's important that statistics develop in tune with changing policy priorities. Through techniques of integration of information, such as natural capital accounting, the relevance of statistical information increases exponentially. To remain relevant, national statistical systems will need to utilize such techniques to improve the integration, the integrated data collection and analysis. Providing the statistics for evidence-based dialogue on today's main policy questions requires continuous methodological development and capable national statistical systems that can adjust quickly to changing demands. The calls for valuing environmental assets and producing alternative measures of GDP underlines the necessity for governments to invest in statistics as a central part of implementing national development strategies. This is why statistics is such an important part of the ongoing discussions in the, on the post-2020 development goals. In 2012, the Rio Plus20 outcome document, world leaders called on the United Nations and its members to address the need for broader measures of progress to complement gross domestic product in order to better inform policy decisions. Asia and the Pacific has an opportunity not only to influence the process of developing complementary indicators to GDP, but also to lead the development of the new concepts and data integration techniques that will underpin these new indicators. As argued in the report on the post-2015 UN Development Agenda, meeting these data integration challenges will require investments in research and experimentation. It will also require a joint effort across governments involving statistical offices and multiple government ministries. National statisticians and development partners in Asia and the Pacific are already working to implement a number of regional statistical capacity development programs for which the work discussed during this workshop is highly relevant. These programs include the regional program on economic statistics, a program to improve population and social statistics, and a regional plan for the global strategy to improve agricultural and rural statistics. Each of these programs are opportunities for national statisticians, for ESCAP, for other partner development partners to engage in research and development towards implementing the SIA, as mentioned by my fellow speakers. ESCAP's involvement with the implementation of the SIA and the supporting environmental statistics collections began this year in earnest, with organizing and providing assistance to member states to conduct assessments of their current capacities for SIA implementation and with developing plans for further improvement. In December this year, ESCAP will organize the first Asia-Pacific expert group meeting on environment statistics, where the SIA will be discussed in much more technical detail than what will be possible this week. Last week, ESCAP organized, in collaboration with the Department of Statistics Malaysia, the first sub-regional course on SIA for ASEAN countries. Given the high demand that's being expressed in this region, we plan to provide much more such assistance in the future. So let me finish by thanking you all for taking time out of your busy schedules And there are a lot of busy people in this room. I had a look at the list of participants. It's a very impressive group of people with representatives from so many different major important players in the quest of accounting for the environment. I want to give a special note of thanks to Sandy for bringing us all together. The initiative came from Sandy, and I want to thank also UNEP for the hard work in preparing for the event, and to our many other partners, including UNSD, for both substantive and financial contributions that made this event possible.